Check it out, I'm here in Fresno, I'm crossing the street, and people are yelling at me. Reporting from Fresno. Save Mart Center, that's where Jose Ramirez is fighting. Getting nothing but love over here. I've been stopped by hundreds of people already. But they're going to the fight, and I'm crossing the street. I'm good, I'm just getting a cup of coffee. Over here, there's no coffee in the building. So everywhere I go, lots of love here in Fresno. Thank you so much everyone for the support. Been stopped non-stop, and I just crossed the street and I heard someone start yelling reporting.
Have a good one, Ali.
Reporting. So there you have a lot of great people here in Fresno. So just gonna get a cup of coffee. It's cold, as you can see. In LA it's hot today. Here it's raining. I didn't bring a jacket, so I definitely don't want to get sick. So I'm just gonna get a cup of tea or coffee, probably see what they have. Hopefully they're still open. And then we're gonna rock and roll from there. Fresno, California. So guys, I got my cup of coffee. Ready to go cover the fight. Jose Ramirez, a couple more hours, he'll be in the ring. He's fighting Jose Pedraza. Jose has a lot to prove, a lot to say. It's his first fight back since the Josh Taylor fight. Jose is a super popular fighter here in the area of Central Valley, Fresno. He does lots for the community. From visiting kids with cancer, to donating stuff to churches, cars and other things, to helping the farm workers. He launched a company where he hires hundreds and hundreds of farm workers. So he's just a huge humanitarian besides being a great fighter. So let's see how he does tonight. Hopefully he wins, hopefully he gets a stoppage. And next fight, if Taylor vacated all the titles, he could fight one more time at 140, win a title, and then go to 47 and go from there. But there you have it, stay tuned. Right here, about to step into the venue. We'll keep you guys posted. Ellie Segbeck, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Segbeck. You can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Segbeck. So, here we have media members showing up. Fights, you won't believe we ran into the future of boxing. Future, but introduce yourself to everybody watching. Tell them where to follow you.
Joey Diarte, 18 years old, 300 plus amateur fights.
One of the best in the nation.
Yeah, one of the best in the nation, man.
Maybe soon to turn pro. Maybe.
Soon, maybe.
Okay, Oscar Valdez against Shakur. Break it down. You know Shakur, you know Oscar?
Yes, sir. I sparred Shakur. He's a real skilled fighter, quick, explosive, but you can't take anything away from Oscar Valdez. He also has extreme power. A lot of rotation power, so I mean it's an interesting fight. I think it's gonna be tougher. It's gonna be a challenge for Shakur, and it's gonna be one of Oscar's tougher fights. So
okay.
It's gonna be interesting.
Canelo Bivol.
Honestly, I got Canelo easy.
Easy? Knockout. Why easy? Yeah.
I don't know. I think Canelo is just he's at a level where he's kind of basically untouchable right now. You know, he's at his peak, and that's how I see it.
Okay, and one more I'm going to ask you. Let's talk about this. If it happens, Benavidez-Charlo.
Benavidez-Charlo, I think that's a good one for Benavidez. I don't think Charlo will stay in front of him. So, but I still got Benavidez. I think Benavidez is just a bigger guy.
Ugas Spence? That's more your weight class.
I got Spence. He's just a different skill set. I think Ugas... You can't take nothing away from him either, you know, a champion. But I think just Spence gets the better of him.
One more time, tell everyone to follow you on Instagram.
Joel_EPV.
Make sure to follow him, representing Bakersfield, California. Stay tuned. This is reporting.